हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर केपी पांडे, आई एम प्रेजेंट बिफोर यू टू डिस्कस थर्मोडायनामिक्स विच इज ए पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस ऑफ सी फोर ऑफ यूजी टू ऑनर्स. लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक दैट इज व्हाट इज थर्मोडायनामिक्स. थर्मोडायनामिक्स एज द नेम थर्मो मींस हीट and dynamics means motion. That is, as is evident by the topic thermodynamics, thermo means heat and dynamics means motion. It means that it should be a subject which relates and dynamics means motion is something which relates heat with motion. That should be thermodynamics. But this topic, that is the name of the topic, name of the chapter, thermodynamics, this is misleading. Actually, thermodynamics, this is not the science which relates heat with motion. Actually, thermodynamics is a topic in a subject which deals heat with energy. It means that thermodynamics is a science which deals heat with energy. Hence, we can define thermodynamics as a science, as a branch of science which deals with heat and energy. That is called thermodynamics. Now, we will start with some very, very important terms which are essential to know to understand the topic, the subject thermodynamics. The terms we are going to discuss, that starts from, that is system first. Terms which are involved in thermodynamics. First, this is system. What is a system? System is a specified portion of universe under study. This is called system. A specified portion of universe which is under study, this is called system. Next is boundary. Boundary separates the system from surrounding. Separates the system from surrounding. Let us take an example of a of water taken in a beaker, and this is subjected to heat. It means that here this water which is placed in this beaker, this constitutes the system. This is system, and the glass wall of the beaker, this glass wall, this is the boundary. This is the boundary, and the adjacent part of the universe. It means that here the atmosphere which is in touch with the glass wall of this beaker, the adjacent part of the beaker, that is the atmosphere which is in contact with the walls of the beaker, this prostitute, this is the surrounding. Surrounding. It means that how can we define surrounding? Surrounding is the adjacent part of the universe which is in contact with the boundary of the system. That is here, the atmosphere which is in contact with the glass wall of the beaker, then this is called surrounding. Now, types of system. We are going to discuss types of system. Here it is very interesting to know that what is universe? All the types of possible system and surrounding that constitute the universe. It means that what is possible in the terms of system and surrounding that constitutes the accumulation of all the system and surrounding that constitutes the universe. Now, types of system. In thermodynamics, the system can be classified into three classes. That is, first is open system. Open system. We will discuss and try to understand all these classes by an example. Again, if we take beaker and water, this is contained in this beaker. Here this water, this is system. And here it is entering into the system. It is entering into the system. That is, this water is subjected to heating. Then what happens here? When the heat will enter into this system, what will happen? The water present in this beaker will vaporize. What is happening here? Here, heat is entering into the system. What is heat? Heat is energy. Energy is entering into the system. And what is water? Water is matter. Here, the open system is such system in which there is interchange of energy and matter. All this system is surrounding. See here? It is entering into the system, that is, energy is entering into the system, water is evaporated. It means that water is coming out, that is disappearing in the surrounding. Hence, such type of system in which there is interchange of energy as well as matter, all the system is surrounding, that type of system is called open system. Now, second one, this is closed system. Closed system, as is named by the topic closed system, it means that such a system in which there is interchange of energy, there is interchange of energy into the system, energy but not matter. Which surrounding? Such type of system in which there is interchange of energy but not matter with the surrounding, that type of system is called closed system. For example, if we take same bottle in which there is water, same bottle here water, and this is placed in heat and placed in sun outside hotel. What happened? Heat that is warm, heat will enter into the system, but as it is sealed hotel, hence the energy that enters that will not come out from the hotel. Such type of system here, heat is entering into the system, that is there is interchange of energy into the system, but matter does not dissipate in surrounding. Such type of system, this is called closed system. This is closed system. And the third type of system, this is isolated system. Isolated system. In this type of system, neither energy nor matter is interchanged. Three types of system, that is closed system, open system, second one is closed system, third is isolated system. Neither energy nor matter, that is interchange the surrounding. This is called isolated system. A high quality thermos glass. We can take example of high quality thermos glass in which there is hot tea. Then for a long time, the warmness or the heat remains constant in the thermos glass, and the matter is also present in that particular thermos glass. That type of system is called isolated system. Now, in thermodynamics, which we deal with physical properties, different type of physical properties. In thermodynamics, there are two types of physical properties. Physical properties, that is property in thermodynamics. There are two types of property in thermodynamics. That is, first is extensive property. Expansive property. All these properties are physical property. Extensive physical property. And second one is intensive property. Intensive property. Such type of physical properties which depends on the size and amount of matter present in the system. In system, this is called, these properties are called expansive property. Expansive property is that it depends on the size as well as on the amount of that system. That is entropy. Entropy is a term which we will use further. Entropy, volume, mass, etc. These properties depends on the size and amount of matter present in the system. These properties are called extensive property and intensive property. Such type of property which does not depend on the size as well as on the amount of matter present in the system, those properties are called intensive properties. It means that such property which does not depend on the side as well as amount of matter present in the system These properties are called intensive properties. And the example of intensive property is the temperature. This is temperature. Refractive index. Refractive index. Density. These all properties do not depend on the amount of matter as well as on the size. And this type of properties are called intensive property. Hence, extensive property then intensive property. Now we are going to discuss what are thermodynamic function. Thermodynamic function.
First type of process
This is isothermal process. Isothermal process. Such type of process in which temperature is kept constant, T2 minus T1 is equal to delta T is equal to Q. It means that such type of process in which temperature is kept constant, this is called isothermal process. Next is adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Here, it remains constant. Here, temperature is kept constant. Temperature is constant. Here, it remains constant. Q2 minus Q1. We express it by Q. Q2 minus Q1 is equal to del Q. Is equal to 0. Here, heat remains constant. There is difference between temperature and heat. The unit of temperature is what? Kelvin, centigrade, etc., Romer, etc. And adiabatic process. In adiabatic process, the unit of heat is joule, calorie, kilocalorie, etc. Hence, isothermal process is such type of process in which temperature is kept constant. This is called isothermal process. Adiabatic process, here heat remains constant. Now, third, isobaric process. Isobaric process. Such type of process in which pressure remains constant. Here, P2 minus P1 is equal to del P is equal to P. If the difference is small, there we can write this difference in terms of dP. And if this is very small, we can write it in terms of del P. P2 minus P1 means that such type of process in which pressure remains constant, this is called isobaric process. Next is, fourth one is isochoric process. Isochoric process. Such type of process in which volume remains constant, that is P2 minus P1 is equal to del V. This is equal to 0. This is isochoric process. And next is, this is very important process. Okay. This is cyclic process. As is evident by the name cyclic, it means that if a system starts from A and after passing through different stages, it again comes to A, then this type of process is called cyclic process. It means that after passing through several stages, the system reverts back, is brought back to its original position, to its initial position, then this type of process is called cyclic process. And it is important to note here that in cyclic process, internal energy remains constant. This is important. Internal energy remains constant. That is del E or dE. In quantum terminology, internal energy is also denoted by U. Internal energy means constant del E or del U or d. this is equal to 0. Internal energy means constant. Hence, we have discussed here isothermal process, such type of process in which temperature remains constant, adiabatic process, the process in which heat remains constant, that is called adiabatic process, isobaric process, pressure remains constant, isobaric process, volume remains constant, and cyclic process. In this type of process, internal energy remains constant. Now, next day is reversible process. Reversible process. This proceeds very slowly. And there are series of equilibrium. This way this. And subsequent to the completion of the process, the process may be brought back to the initial position. It means that जब तक ये प्रोसेस पूरा नहीं हो जाता है ना, तब तक बीच में से इसको वापस इसकी प्रारंभिक अवस्था में ला सकते हैं. सब्सिक्वेंट टू द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द प्रोसेस कैन बी ब्रॉट बैक टू इट्स इनिशियल पोजीशन. दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस. दिस इज आइडियल प्रोसेस. रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस इज आइडियल प्रोसेस एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज वेरी स्लो प्रोसेस. दिस प्रोसेस इज वेरी स्लोली. एंड नाउ irreversible process. Irreversible process. All the natural processes are irreversible in nature. It means that there is no time to find an equilibrium, to establish the equilibrium in the process. All the natural processes, it means that the actually occurring processes are but irreversible in nature, and these processes are called irreversible process. Now we are going to discuss the first law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics. First law of thermodynamics is nothing but it is another form of law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy. First law of thermodynamics is another form of law of conservation of energy. And let us try to understand this law by means of an example. If we have taken here a cylinder fitted with weightless and frictionless piston. This is weightless and frictionless piston. And here, the cylinder will constitute the system. This contains one bowl of ideal gas. If dq amount of heat is implemented into the system, equal amount of heat engineering into the system, what will happen? The gas, which is encased in this wetless and frictionless cylinder, which is fitted with wetless and frictionless piston, and what happens? The gas encased in this cylinder, that will expand. And as the piston is wetless and frictionless, hence this will come here. Hence, what is happening here? Equal amount of heat is entering into the system and it increases the internal energy of the system by dE and plus W. W is the work done by the system. This is equal to dE plus W. dQ means a small amount of heat is entering into the system. This is the increment in internal energy and W is the amount of work done by the system. That is, piston is coming a lot by the expansion of this gas and P is the applied pressure. Hence, we can write it as dQ is equal to dE plus P into dV. P is the pressure and dV is the change in volume. Force into distance, that is called work done. P into dV, this is equation number 1. And as in modern terminology, internal energy, this may be represented by E or U. In modern terminology, U is U. Hence, we can write this equation as dQ, Q is equal to del U and plus del U. In modern terminology, the statement of the equation of first order term can be represented by this equation. Here, dQ is equal to dE plus W, dQ is equal to dE plus PdV, dQ is the small amount of heat which is entering into the system, D is the increment in internal energy, and W is the work done by the system. This is the expression. Then, how can we define first law of thermodynamics? We can define first law of thermodynamics as E. If it is absorbed by the system, then the amount of heat entering into the system is equal to increment in internal energy equal to it means that the amount of heat absorbed by the system, this is equal to the amount of heat absorbed by the system is equal to the sum total of incrementing internal energy and work done by the system. That is, dQ equal to dE plus W. dQ equal to dE plus W. Now, for isothermal system, condition A. Isothermal system. Isothermal system, what happens? Temperature remains constant. Adiabatic system. Heat remains constant. Then what will happen in this system? dQ is equal to 0. Hence, from equation 3, 0 is equal to dE plus W, or W is equal to minus dE. Adiabatic process, isothermal system here, this system here, this is adiabatic process. For adiabatic process, what happens? dQ is constant, dQ is equal to 0, and 0 is equal to dE plus W is equal to minus dE. Next, for cycling process, dE is equal to 0, change in internal energy is 0, and by the expression of first law, that is dQ is equal to D plus W, D is 0, or dQ is equal to W. dQ is equal to W. And in cyclic process, the amount of heat entering into the system, that is equal to work done of the system. Hence, we have discussed here the first law of thermodynamics. The first law of thermodynamics is, this is a type of law of conservation of energy. It states that if heat is entering into a system, then part of the heat that is converted into internal energy, and work done is done by this part of the heat entering into the system. And conditions are there for adiabatic process, dQ is equal to 0, and for cyclic process, dE is equal to 0. Hence, heat entering into the system, this is completely converted into work in cyclic process. As in cyclic process, the internal energy becomes 0, change in internal energy becomes